we consider an application that can be formulated as a longest pass problem in a network with no cycle. It means that the shortest pass algorithm can be applied after the signs of all the costs have been changed. The application is called a Program Evaluation and Review Technique, and the acronym is PERT, PERT. We consider a project which is involving M tasks to be performed. Each task has a duration, and each task has a list of predecessors. For example, let's take a project where we need to prepare a pizza. We have 4 tasks to perform. We need to buy the ingredients. We need to prepare the sauce. We need to prepare the dough. And we need to bake the pizza. Buying the ingredients takes 30 minutes. Preparing the sauce takes 20 minutes. Preparing the dough takes 4 hours. And the baking takes 12 minutes. Each task has a list of predecessors. In order to be able to prepare the sauce, we need task 1 to be completed, so buying the ingredients. In order to be able to prepare the dough, we also need task 1 to be finished, buying the ingredients. And in order to be able to bake the pizza, we need task 2 and 3 to be finished. So that's what we mean by predecessor. It's a task that needs to be terminated before the current task can start. In the context of this project, there are 2 questions that we would like to address. What is the minimum duration of the whole project? And what are the tasks that cannot suffer any delay without delaying the whole project? That's what we will be trying to address. We will model this problem using a network. Each node will represent a task. In our pizza example, we have 4 tasks. So we have 4 nodes, 1 to buy the ingredient, 1 to prepare the sauce, 1 to prepare the dough, and 1 to bake the pizza. We had 2 nodes, 1 that represents the beginning of the project, that we denote by O, and 1 that represents the end of the project, that we denote by D. So if we have n tasks, we have n plus 2 nodes in the network. Now we need to include an arc each time we have a precedence condition. We've seen that in order to start making the sauce, the task buying the ingredients must be completed. So we have this predecessor here. Same thing for the dough. We have this preceding condition. And we have seen that in order to start baking the pizza, both task 2 and task 3 must be completed. So this is represented by these 2 arrows. Now, the node begin, the origin node here, must be a predecessor of every task. So in this case, it's sufficient to make it a predecessor of the buy task. And symmetrically, the node end must be a successor of all the tasks. In that case, it is a successor of the bake. So it means that the project will not be finished until baking the pizza is finished. So we have a network. Now we need to add a cost on each arc. The idea is to assign each arc with the duration of the task represented by the upstream node. So this is not a real task, so its duration will be 0. Buying the ingredient takes 30 minutes, so on each arc that leaves this node, we put 30. Preparing the sauce takes 20 minutes, so we put 20 on this arc. Preparing the dough takes 4 hours, so we put 240 on this arc. And baking the pizza takes 12 minutes, so we put 12 minutes on this arc. Now that we have a network, we can actually address the 2 questions that we had in mind, which are, what is the minimum duration of the project? And what are the tasks that do not tolerate any delay without delaying the project? In order to do that, we calculate the longest pass in the network. Note that this network by construction does not contain any loop, any cycle, because it's a precedence network. Therefore, the shortest pass algorithm can be used on the network where all the costs have a different sign. The longest pass is composed of the list of tasks that we will call critical, meaning tasks that cannot be delayed without delaying the project. Indeed, along this pass, each task starts immediately after the previous one is done. So we buy the ingredients, it takes 30 minutes. Immediately after, we prepare the dough. It takes 4 hours. Immediately after we bake the pizza, it takes 12 minutes. Now, if you look at preparing the sauce now, well, we have a choice. We don't need to start preparing the sauce directly after buying the ingredients. We need, in any case, to wait for the dough to be ready, so we have 4 hours. We can take any 20 minutes within these 4 hours, and it will be fine. So this is not a critical task. It shows that answering these two questions, what is the minimum duration of the project, and what are the tasks that do not tolerate any delay without delaying the project, amounts to calculate the longest path in the network. The length of the longest path is the minimum duration of the project, and all the tasks along the longest path are critical, meaning that they do not tolerate any delay. In project management, a cycle-free network represents the precedence of various tasks in a project. In that case, we can identify critical tasks by calculating the longest path in this network. And because there is no cycle, we can use the shortest path algorithm to do that.